Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Windward Buddhist Temple's Remembrance Service. I hope everyone had a wonderful Thanksgiving, and I'm really especially happy to see our junior YBA members in the audience today. My name is Neil, and I will be your MC today. We'll begin with the ringing of the temple bell, or kansho. It signifies the beginning of a temple service. It is a deep and sacred ritual steeped in ancient tradition. It is the calling of the people to come together to listen to the Dharma teachings. The temple bell represents the gratitude and deep appreciation of the members, friends, and guests of Windward Buddhist Temple. Please sit quietly in your seat. Please rise for the meditation, followed by the chanting of the Vandana and Ti-Sarana by the congregation in Pali and English, located on page 165 in the Brown Praises of the Buddha book.
Thank you. Namo Amida Butsu Namanda Namanda.
Please be seated. At this time, Reverend Barbara Brennan will lead San Bu Jo and our aspiration.
Family and friends who have left us, let us deeply reflect on the transience and uncertainty of life, so that we may awaken to a true understanding of things as they are, not relying on our limited understanding, but Amida's embracing life. Let us live our lives in gratitude for the great benevolence we have received from our teachers, family, and friends. As we remember those family members, let us seek to repay our debt to those we have lost for their gifts to us by deeply listening to the Buddhist teachings, so that as we realize Amida's wisdom, we may manifest compassion to all beings. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namanda.
We will now have the remembrance of those who passed away this month in any year, both individuals and pets. Reverend Brennan will hit the gong several times to start this portion of the service. Then the names of the deceased will be announced. Please go forward to offer incense. Then Reverend Brennan will hit the daiking again for the next name. After the last name is called, she will hit the gong several times and then go directly into the sutra, verses reaffirming the vows on page 117 in the red Jodo Shinshu service book. Taro Sumikawa Sumie Asada. Tadayuki Nishita. Sakiko Matsuda. Haru Matsuda. Sawayo Hiramoto. Alpha Kaneko. Matsue Miyamoto. Junichi Fukumoto.
Of suffering, may throughout the universe. May I not attain Buddhahood. I will practice the golden path, wisely, mindfully, free of greed. Seek to reach the supreme way. Be a guide to one and all. May my power shine great light to illumine and dispel the darkness of the three poisons and save all from suffering. Eyes of wisdom I'll remove the darkness of ignorance. I will close all evil paths, open gates of highest good. When I attain Buddhahood, light will shine throughout all lands, light brighter than sun and moon, outshining all heavenly lights, giving my virtues to all, not forsaking anyone. I will proclaim the Dharma like the roar of a great lion, bowing before all Buddhas, steadfastly gaining virtues, with wisdom fulfilling my vows. I shall be a guide to all, like the wisdom of my teacher. May my wisdom also shine all throughout the universe and illumine one and all. If I shall fulfill these vows, may all lands tremble with joy from the heavens. Wondrous flowers rain down upon all the lands. Namanda.
Please rise and turn to page 44 in the purple WBT supplemental service book in the back pocket of the chair in front of you for the recitation, Our Pledge. Please continue to stand for the Gatha Hotokesama 2 on page 74 in the Brown Praises of the Buddha Gatha book. Please be seated. Our Dharma message this morning will be delivered by Reverend Barbara Brennan.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. I'm still making these little mistakes, so please bear with me. Thanksgiving Day not only gave us a chance to be with family and friends and to eat well, basically, maybe overeat. I was lucky I didn't have to cook the turkey this year. So lucky. My daughter decided that she wanted to do it because her partner, whose family lives in Kaneohe, she wanted to have everybody get together, so it was the first time. So there were 6 kids, a baby, and 11 adults, 2 turkeys, and all the additions made for a delicious and traditional gathering, for which we were very grateful. Then last week, Reverend Bert and I attended the 61st Nuuanu Valley Interfaith Thanksgiving Service. It is the longest running interfaith service in Hawaii. So different religious communities along the Nuuanu Valley Corridor always come together to share their sacred scriptures and perspectives in harmony, love, and peace, and to express gratitude. And each year, a collection is made which benefits a worthy organization. This year, it went to Kinai Eha, the Kauailoa Youth and Family Wellness Center in Kailua. You may have heard of it. Kinai Eha means to extinguish pain, and so it provides an alternate education option to Opio, and I assume those are the, you know, students and people who are having a hard time in life. They're in need of seeking purpose, personal empowerment, education, Hawaiian culture, identity and connection, workforce training in construction and the trades, community service and leadership. My talk today is about being grateful, and I want to share the following with you. I'm grateful for many things. The warm welcome all of you have given me as your new minister. The way everyone works together, how your officers, the board, take their jobs at heart. To Joy and Lisa for making such wonderful music each week. To all the willing and able MCs. Kuki's wealth of knowledge in showing me how to set up the altar as well as sharing other information. The board members keep the temple going. The program committee creates special events and programs. And then there's Ryan, being the excellent techie he is, with such skills to share the Dharma online through the website, the WBT website, and on YouTube. The important mentorship I have in Reverend Burt, who has given so much time in providing guidance and critical training in my learning the ropes as a temple minister. In 2016 is when I received Tokudō, but my job at Betsuin was to help the ministers set up the altar and do various things. So I was never in charge of doing something as great as I have here. So I am very grateful to be part of this caring sangha. And it's so nice to see the kids who do come. Everybody has problems trying to get their kids to come to Dharma school. I had trouble when my kids were young. It was like they wanted to sleep in, and I'd be yelling at them and telling them, you have to get dressed, you know, but so be it. They're really good kids. This is an aside, but my son is very involved at Betsuin and Honganji Mission School, so it really makes me feel good about that. Well, so what does gratitude mean? What does it mean to be grateful? This is a special opportunity to share some thoughts with you on the Buddha's teachings, which are universal teachings of gratitude. The Reverend Tai Tetsu Unno, a scholar and Shin Buddhist minister that many of you know and lectured over here many times, he published in a pamphlet form one of his talks, which was entitled Gratitude, Its Source and Power. So I got a lot of ideas of what I'm going to share with you today from that booklet. In the preface, Reverend William Masuda wrote, the booklet expresses the basic attitude of the person living within the Nembutsu and manifesting the timeless power of Amida Buddha's wisdom and compassion as a source of gratitude itself, for life itself. The original term for gratitude in Japanese is on, which primarily means kindness, goodness, grace, benevolence, etc. Everything that we receive in life sustains us by virtue of on. The secondary meaning is our appreciation for this gift of life, our deep wish to compensate or repay. It is this secondary meaning that is conveyed by the English word gratitude. And in fact, according to Reverend Uno, this sense of wanting to return favors, blessings, and gifts is understood as a basic ethical principle in the life of many Buddhas. In addition, traditionally in Buddhism, we speak of the four gratitudes, considered as objects of our devotion and appreciation. First, it includes mother. Second, father. Third, Buddha or Tathagata. And fourth, teacher of the Dharma. They give us life, nourish us, and enrich our existence. To them, we ought to feel infinite gratitude. Reverend Uno explains, in order for us to be grateful for anything, we must be able to recognize and acknowledge things done for us. If we are not aware of the good that comes our way, no matter how many blessings we receive, there's no way that we can feel any sense of gratitude. We are limited in our awareness of the care, concern, and the love our parents have showered upon us, especially in the first few years of our infancy, without which we would not be here today. Even in adulthood, there's so many things that others have done and are doing for us that we never know about. Even more problematic are the things that we take for granted: the air we breathe, the water we drink, the food we eat. For our egos, our bono, the desires of our ego are endless. The more we get, the more we want. Not only do we fail to recognize the favors and kindnesses that others have done for us because of our egos, our self-concern, we are unaware of the pain that we have inflicted on others. Reflecting on the four gratitudes, mother, father, Buddha, and teacher of the Dharma, how many of us really and truly live in thankfulness for the countless gifts we receive from them? Reverend Uno shares a story illustrating the nature of our limited awareness. There was a famous Shin teacher who lived over 100 years ago in Japan. His name is Jokan Shikazumi. As a minister, he wore the traditional black robe, the undergarment of which is white. Once his mother wove a white cloth on an old hand loom, sewed it herself, and presented it to her son. When her son received it, he kind of laughed, thinking, how silly of mother to weave the cloth when I could go out and buy a ready-made one at the department store. It's much cheaper, and she doesn't have to spend so many hours on the loom. Later, he did go out and buy a ready-made white robe. But after several washings, the store-bought robe lost its shape, tore at the seams, and eventually wore out. Whereas the robe his mother had made kept its shape, never tore apart, even after countless washings. Chikazumi realized that what endured was the hidden love and concern of the mother woven into the cloth and put into a hand-stitched robe. Although it took some time for him to realize his lack of appreciation for his mother's efforts, once he became aware of it, he was deeply grateful to her every time he wore the robe, even after she departed from this world. In his article, The Path of Gratitude, written in the Lion's Roar magazine, Jeff Wilson says that, as a Shin Buddhist, my primary practice isn't meditation, sutra study, ritual, or precepts. All of these can be valuable, but in Shin Buddhism, our main focus is the practice of gratitude through the recitation of the Nembutsu, Namo Amida Butsu. For Shin Buddhists, being aware of our interconnectedness involves being aware of the teachings of Amida Buddha and Shinran Shonin to acknowledge the generosity of all who come into our lives. As we reflect on gratefulness, on the generosity for the caring and love of our mothers, fathers, our teachers, and friends, we have been given this life in the Dharma, the Nembutsu Namo Amida Butsu, to guide us every day. We can wake up each morning, go in front of the altar, light the candle, light incense, ring the bell, and with hands together, express our gratitude for this unrepeatable life. Yes, we can try to live each day in appreciation, even with its ups and downs. Because we are embraced by the compassion and wisdom which is Amida Buddha. Please join me in Gatha. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namandab, namandab. I'm sorry I kind of stuttered during this talk because my printer wasn't working. So it's really hard to receive something like this. So I was trying to follow my, you know, and I would get lost. So I apologize, but that happens sometimes. Anyway.
Thank you very much, Reverend Brennan, for reminding us to live a life of gratitude. Please rise for the Gatha, Quest of Life, on page 126 in the Brown Praises of the Buddha book, and continue to stand for the Nembutsu.
Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu.
Please be seated. This concludes our service for this morning. And now it's time for announcements with Cynthia. This one, yeah? That's the one you need. Sorry.
Thank you, Neil. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Okay. I get to announce the guests. And I got the yellow sheet here. I mean, yellow, pink. Sorry. Okay. Anyway, after I call your name, could you please rise so that everyone can acknowledge you? Okay, the guests, Mel and Irene Ida, please stand. I'm glad to see you're all well. Thank you. And also, all the junior YBA students that are here, could you please rise, the ones that are in this. Okay. Thank you. They're cooking up a good meal for us.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I would like to thank all the volunteers that helped with today's remembrance service. We could not have done it without you. Thank you very, very much. A fresh batch of bitter melon namasu has been made. If you are interested, we will have it available after service today for $6 per carton. Please see Roy, he'll be at the desk. Just a few reminders. There will be no service here at the temple next Sunday. However, that Sunday, there will be a Bodhi Day service at the Higashi Honganji Mission at 9:30, which will be sponsored by the Hawaii Buddhist Council. You are welcome to attend that service, and our Bodhi Day service will be held on December 11th. Our Bodhi Day service on December 11th will be followed by our annual general membership meeting. The installation of our 2023 officers and board of directors will be held at that time. Lunch and a program will follow. Today is the last day to turn in your Bodhi tree gift items to Roy for the Salvation Army. Thank you very much once again for participating in this joint membership effort to provide a few families with a little happiness during the holidays. Roy, would you like to say anything?
I just wanted to personally thank everyone that participated in the Bodhi Tree project. It was a very successful event, and I think we made 29 keikis and kapunas have a little bit happier holiday season this year. So thank you very much.
I'm asking too.
That's what it said. Where is it going?
I believe the service, the Bodhi Day service, is not at Higashi, but it's at the Jodo Shu Temple.
In Makiki?
In Makiki.
Right? That's the building, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, is it? Yeah. And I think it's at 9:30 also. So. It's also on Zoom, so if you don't want to go there, then you can stay home and in your jammies and watch it.
So Jodo Shu Mission by Shriners Hospital, is that the one?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
Not Higashi.
Jodo Shu. Jodo Shinshu.
Jodo Shu.
Oh, Jodo Shu. Oh. Ha. Forget it. You got that straight? Okay. Okay, and once again, thank you for supporting our country market pop-up table last Sunday. We were pleased to have sold as much as we did. Thanks again. Now, are there any other announcements? Joy, you want to announce your...
Good morning. Thanks for waiting so patiently for our breakfast or brunch or whatever. So the junior YBA, some of them have had to leave, but we have still a bunch of our junior YBA members and some of their parents that helped. On the menu is scrambled eggs, Portuguese sausage, bacon, and fruits, lots of fruits, yeah, and rice. So thank you. We hope you join us. We have a little donation container in the front if you are interested and would like to donate to the Junior Young Buddhist Association. We really much appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Joy. Okay, in closing, let us recite the words of thanksgiving. It's found in your red Jodo Shinshu service book on page 126. Why are you laughing? Okay. We are truly grateful for this wonderful food, a gift of life. May we share its benefits with all beings. As we partake of this food, let us remember Amida Buddha's compassion, which surrounds all people and all forms of life. Namo Amida Butsu. Itadakimasu. Thank you very much, everyone.